screen.
Our sisters also are there. Why they have to click on presenting?
When they present, now they become small.
That now screen has become small. You see.
I think the instructions have to be given first.
Yes, good.
We sisters, we begin now. Good morning.
PPT has become very small. We cannot see. PPT has become very small screen because one sister came in between presenting. So now PPT has become very small.
That PPT is not going to be presented.
Father has to do.
Hello.
Father has to redo it again.
Yeah, please listen to me. We are going to begin the webinar. First is not the PPT. First, Sister Flori Meneses from Pune province will begin our webinar. So, Flori, over to you. Please start.
Okay. Thank you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, dear sisters. It is indeed a privilege for me to welcome all of you for this international webinar on eco-spirituality for our times. We begin with a short prayer. Let us get connected to the divine by invoking his presence as we make the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Triune God, wondrous community of infinite love, envelop us with the aura of the divine. We, your creatures, are interconnected, intertwined in the web of your divine love in the whole universe. We reflect today on eco-spirituality. Teach us to contemplate you in the beauty of the universe. For all the things speak of you. Awaken our praise and thankfulness for every being that you have made. Pope Francis, who is so committed to care for our common home, inspires us and people throughout the world to do the same. Awaken us to the cry of the poor and the earth, to protect all life, to prepare for a better future, for the coming of your kingdom of justice, peace, love, and beauty. Wake us to deepen our eco-spirituality as we celebrate the season of creation. We pray for God's grace to grow deeper in our respect and care for his creation, our common home. May we recognize the sacredness of God's creatures as signs of his wondrous love. May we have the courage to turn from the selfish consumption of resources meant for all and to see the impacts of our choices on the poor and the vulnerable. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear sisters, I am Flori, member of C-Crop, chosen consortium to reach out to the periphery. Sister Rosalie Joseph, our general counselor, is a link person for this commission, and Sister Prema Chavalur is the coordinator. So I invite Sister Prema to extend a formal welcome to you for our first international webinar on approaches of eco-spirituality. Over to you, Sister Prema.
Hi, everyone. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to each and every one of you, dear sisters, to today's webinar on eco-spirituality. Your presence makes me very happy and excited. It's amazing that we are here from four continents to enhance our spiritual horizon. We are here from almost 217 communities of our congregation. I'm aware that a few communities may not be present here due to several other reasons. Yet, we are a large band of sisters ready to attend the webinar on eco-spirituality of our time. Probably this will go on record as one of the largest gatherings of the Sisters of the Cross during this pandemic episode. Alvin Toffler, in his book, Future Shock, which many of you would have read, has mentioned enough about the disaster of this planet Earth when he spoke of development. I remember vividly he spoke about the throwaway society that was emerging then. I'm sure that none will object to me in this gathering if I say we are all prey to this type of society today. The book World Without Us by Alan Weisman speaks of the irreversible damage we have done to this planet. He speaks of a similar situation that this present pandemic has done. If nobody is here on this earth, it would be a cleaner planet, and so the entire universe will be free of all types of pollution and will begin its cleansing and survival process. Realizing and recognizing the sacredness of nature, Earth, our mother, and the universe will not only enhance our spirituality, but also will impel us to change our way of life to be more earth-friendly. I am pleased to add my voice of welcome once again to this webinar. On behalf of Sister Elizabeth Miranda, our Superior General, and her team, Sister Rosalie, the link person, and Crossing Consortium to reach out to the periphery, the crop. I also welcome Father Robert Adhikal SJ, a person with whom I have worked in an organization called Tharmitra, which means Friends of Trees. I'm extremely grateful to him for accepting our invitation to speak to us on eco-spirituality of our time. Wish you all the best, Father Robert. Now, over to the moderator, Sister Flori Meneses from the province of Pune. Over to you, Sister Flori.
Thank you. Thank you, Sister, for your warm welcome. Before we begin, we have a few requests. Sisters, kindly mute your audios so that we don't get disturbed by the outside sounds. We are on Google Meet. If you have difficulty in logging through Google Meet app, there is also a YouTube link sent to you. Please avoid sharing your screens. You can send your questions, doubts in the chat box. It will be taken up at the end of the session. We are indeed privileged to have Dr. Father Robert Adhikal SJ the founder and director of Taru Mitra Patna, as the resource person for today's webinar. Taru Mitra is a nationwide students' movement to promote ecological sensitivity in India. He was conferred by Holy Cross Boston University the doctorate for his outstanding contribution to save the Mother Earth. Dr. Father Robert, with his team, has established various Taru Mitra clubs in schools and colleges all over India. He gives his life in conscientizing people of all walks of life, in giving seminars and training on eco-spirituality and other related topics. He is a green man who taught almost 30 years ago the need to preserve and protect the environment. I would say he is an artist and a mystic of our time with new dreams and novel way of living. Dear Father Robert, we are extremely happy to have you today and eagerly waiting to hear your words of wisdom on how to live earth-friendly lives. Wishing you all the best, and over to you, dear Father Robert.
Thank you, Sister Flory. Thank you, Prema. And for that beautiful prayer and the introduction. Am I audible?
Yes, Father.
Okay. So where am I sitting? I'll start my presentation.
Yes, Father.
This is a map of India, and I am sitting almost towards the center. Up there's a red mark there.
Father, and he has not come as a full screen.
Robert, you need to say slideshow. Go to slideshow, then it will come on the full screen. Go to slideshow on your laptop. Slideshow in that same small window. Slideshow from the beginning. Found it?
Not yet.
I can see it here. Slideshow, wherever you are, same place, go there, slideshow from the beginning. As you do it on a normal screen.
Yeah, I'm trying to, something comes and stops me from doing that. Okay, no.
Slideshow from the beginning. Slideshow is on the left hand side. Or somewhere in the middle, and then from the beginning is the left hand side. I'm pointing it out on my, can you see it? Slideshow from the beginning, slideshow, and then go to from the beginning.
This is, I can see you, Mudita.
Robert, see, normally when we do a slideshow program, same way. So what is on your screen, go just to the slideshow, and then click at slideshow, and then go to from the beginning. Like the normal way we do it. You're still, okay, go to slideshow.
Full screen, go.
Go to slideshow.
You are still not on slideshow. Like we normally do.
No, I cannot go there because something comes and blocks it.
I can see it. See, I'm pointing it out also here. Slideshow. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In the middle somewhere, slideshow is showing. Slideshow.
Yeah.
Found it?
No.
How is that day? He cannot go.
But it is better now.
Yeah, at least we can see. It's not showing the full screen, but we can see the small screen.
Who is presenting now? Somebody else is trying to present.
Lot of presenters. Robert, you found or didn't find?
See, I can't start the PowerPoint.
Father, you start from the beginning as you did it. You close the... Listen, you go to the present now.
No, Mudita is knowledgeable there.
I did it this afternoon, so I learned it before I had to give my talk. I did it for...
Just to see.
Hello. It's quite visible. I think you can go ahead with this.
Yeah, go ahead then. I can see the screen and I can see the slideshow also.
No, it is not the ordinary, this one, no. It is not come now. It is when
please, you can go ahead with this, sister.
And okay. It is very heavy. That's why I'm not able to send it to you. So somebody else is presenting.
Is presenting.
Sisters, please don't present. They are by mistake, they are touching that button.
Yeah.
So then I did the father.
Icon. Don't touch that icon.
Louisa D'Souza is presenting. She has to stop presenting.
Who is that presenting?
Louisa D'Souza is presenting. She has to stop presenting.
Okay, now it is stopped.
Sister, I think we can go ahead with this. It's quite visible.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
It came as a full screen just now. I don't.
Yes,
he is a big IT man and he's not able to do that.
It's quite visible, Father. You can go ahead.
Yeah, I cannot go. It doesn't move.
Okay.
You know, friends, these are new technologies. We need some time to get used to it. Very often we burn into problems. The other day from Vatican, they were showing something, suddenly everything went off of the screen. Took a half an hour for them to work it out.
Mudita. Let father start from the beginning. That is better.
Yeah.
Listen, the screen doesn't change because I can't get into the PowerPoint mode.
Father, you pin it.
Hey, instead of wasting time, I think we can go ahead, please.
Who is wasting time, by the way?
It doesn't have anybody there.
I think this computer is hanging up.
It looks like that.
This tapping not going.
Mm-hmm. We'll open that one. So
Robert, it's 7 from the left. From the left, slideshow is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I am clicking on.
That's what he is telling. He cannot go. I don't know. That's what his computer got stuck. What a thing, you know.
You know, it happens.
Oh, slide is not in the next slide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8.
From the left, 8. Slideshow. From the left, 8. Got it?
No, wonderful. it doesn't work on that.
Just click.
I clicked on that. No.
It's not.
Why do you go to slideshow, Modita? He has to take the full screen.
Yes, but slideshow will give the full screen. Like TV. Prema, slideshow will give the full screen. I did it in the afternoon. At 2 o'clock, I was on the another webinar and I gave the talk, so that's why I learnt it.
Okay. Father, can you go slide by slide even if you don't get the full screen?
I'm trying to do that.
Not moving. That's what he got stuck. His computer is hanging.
Okay. You want to begin all over again, Robert?
Yeah.
Okay. Close down whatever you have.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me call you. Close down whatever you have. Then just keep your PPT open in advance.
Just wait for a moment.
Okay.
Okay.
You kept your PPT open and minimize it.
Now it's working.
Wonderful. Now just go to slideshow and press slideshow.
Yeah.
That's it. Perfect.
Can you see the big group picture?
Wonderful.
Okay. Welcome to our SCC friends. Sister Prema SCC and her initiative. Appreciate she joined us in Perumithra as a pioneer, and she worked with us 5 years, and she's standing with some of the volunteers of that period. Thank you, Prema. I was impressed by the SCC mission to reveal to all the merciful love of the Father and the liberating power of the Paschal mystery. And I thought our concern today is an expression of this. See, Father Thomas Berry, he died 2009, very perhaps one of the most accepted theologians in America. He used to say, he suggested that we seek the fourfold wisdom of science, religion, women, and the indigenous people to understand the crisis we face today. You know, the fourfold wisdom to understand the situation today. So women play a very important role. So also the indigenous people. See, we have distinct narratives in our Catholic, Christian, and the Judeo tradition. The perspectives on the providence of God towards the creation. You know, God is like a shepherd. He looks after everything. And he said, look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow, nor do they reap. They gather nothing in barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. This is a providence. And in Indian tradition, there was a huge war, world war in India, way back, I don't know how many thousands of years back, and there was a war between two factions, and then God himself came down and became the charioteer of the main fighter. And in the during the war, there's a discussion takes place. The whole book called Bhagavad Gita is a narrative of that war, the discussion, and in which the Lord told the man, the fighter, Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. In the Vaishnava tradition, it means whenever there is a problem on the planet, I myself take birth and come down and take care of it. Whenever good people are in trouble, whenever evil abounds, I come and take care of it. Don't worry. The providence in the Indian perspective. And there is another tradition which looks at the creation as the dance of the Lord Shiva. The dance is the creation. There is an intimate connection between God and the creation. It is there we have the scientific narratives started by the mystic Tehardeh Chardin S.J., a reputed paleontologist. He was a scientist from France. And he gave us a different vision of what happens on the planet in our times today. We have another thinker called Aurobindo. They both thought alike. A very positive view of history by Sri Aurobindo and Tehardeh Chardin. Both of them were kept at abeyance in the sense they were not accepted easily. But today, Tehardeh Chardin especially is accepted in the church. See, I'm talking about all these to understand, you know, this virus we have around us, COVID virus. I think no world war has affected as much as the war with this small virus. How do you understand it? What happened to the providence of God? What happened to the offer that God himself will come down and take care of us? The temples, the churches, they are all closed. And people, poor people are walking from the metros, large metros like Bombay and Delhi. People are walking away. Not millions and millions of people. No, it was tough on them walking for 2,000 kilometers. This exodus that took place after January this year. It was untold suffering for our people. Then in June, we organized a webinar, 25 schools from Nepal, Bangladesh and India, in which students took part and they said, you know, things are not so bad because they said the nature is far better now, less pollution. So COVID is not a bad idea. And I thought, children, what a stupid way of saying. When people are dying in large numbers, you are saying the creation is okay? The students stated COVID has been a blessing in disguise. I don't know, maybe a middle class way of thinking. To understand this exodus, the pain and anguish of millions of people. See, I tend to say Earth had good days and bad days. Ever since the Earth was born out of the sun, roughly 4.5 billion years back, 450 crores in Indian terms, the Earth was born. Further, Tehardeh Chardin S.J. and his Phenomenon of Man, his book, was a fresh scientific spirit in the church. He was not accepted. He was almost thrown out of the Jesuit society for saying this. But today, recently, Pope Francis said, I'm so happy we had a man of his status to enlighten us. We remember Father Tayarde Sharadan S.J. and he is thinking today. In Tayarde's language, the earth in his development, there is a moment the earth was dominated by dinosaurs. Some of them very clever and very cruel. You know, those of you who watched the Jurassic Park series, you would know how ferocious they were. And most dangerous among them was spinosaurs. They were dangerous because they were very strong and they could walk on the land and go under the sea and swim. Nobody could escape them. These animals did not have a chance. These animals which are large enough, but they couldn't survive because the dinosaurs, when they come, they are so ferocious. The Hollywood has made out this film, and let me see if this will play. Different varieties of dinosaurs. This way, 6 varieties of dinosaurs come. I don't have time to show all of them. We'll move ahead. The last one. See, life was brutish and short. Even the mammoths did not have a chance. These were huge animals. They couldn't survive. Only dinosaurs. Imagine a 100,000 dinosaurs moving through America, through South America, Amazon and all that. Nothing could live there. And that was very bad day for all the animals. Then something miraculous takes place. This huge meteorite from the outer sky comes and hits the earth. The meteorite fell on the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico 65 million years back. 65 million years back, this happened. And this meteorite raised so much of dust. It completely covered the sky and the sun disappeared. The plants all died and dinosaurs disappeared. This was a large one, 80 kilometers wide. We have the Chicxulub crater in Mexico, where we can see the impact of that today. The Yucatan today. And this wiped out the dinosaurs completely from the earth. The meteorite wiped out the giant dinosaurs. Earth had good days and bad days. The meteorite was bad for dinosaurs. That we all agree is bad for dinosaurs. For the rest of them, it was a great idea. Once the dinosaurs were out, small animals thrived. All varieties of animals, they could thrive. And, you know, look at the varieties of monkeys. They could survive. And some monkeys were large and big. They were gregarious creatures. They lived together and worked together and fought together. And this continued for next million years. And 25 lakhs years back, Africa had plenty of rains and grass grew in the deserts. And the rain brought grass and grass was all over. This created no problem for grazing animals, but it was bad for monkeys. Walking on four legs among the grass was bad for the monkeys. It was not simply possible. And so the monkeys adapted, balanced to walk on two legs. You know, while it was grass growing was perhaps bad for the monkeys, in the long run they overcame their difficulties and they became the smart monkeys. And they were blessed, since they were walking, the head was straight on their head. And these monkeys in the present day South Africa turned out to be more advanced than other primates. That's how Father Shardan says it. See, the unique agility of the thumbs helped them to develop tools. See, varieties of monkeys. And they moved and progressed and evolved. The human lineage. And today we have a variety known as Homo zoomis is here. First time in history, we have created the Zoom technology, today Google Meet. And we are sitting around the universe and participate in the common programs together. Was the meteorite a good one for 65 million years back? Yeah, I suppose 1.3 billion Indians are happy that it fell. because of which we are here. If the dinosaurs were here, we would not be here. The providence of God, no, Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. That the providence of God sees to every disaster to take place and somehow helps, certain species to develop, to grow. We need to redefine providence in a broader way now. Providence. That, the earth was born of an explosion in the mother star 4.5 billion years back. Great idea. If you have time, you must go to YouTube. I'm not going to show it here. Write it down somewhere. Big History in 18 minutes. Professor David Christian explains this process in a scientific way, in a modern way. He has been to India, came and spent time in Goa, met a lot of educationalists. He says there are Goldilocks moments in history. In history, certain moments are Goldilocks. You have heard the story of Goldilocks, the nursery story of children, where the story is this girl, Goldilocks, her name is Goldilocks. She was very friendly with the bears. So one day she went to visit them in the forest and cave, and she found three bowls of porridge. One was extremely hot, she couldn't even touch it. Another was so cold, she couldn't take it. And the third was neither hot nor cold. And she could eat that. She ate up the thing. And see, Goldilocks moment is when things are neither too hot nor too cold. You go to that video of Professor David Christian, he explains this process so well. Certain moments called Goldilocks threshold moments, he calls it. In the history of the planet, certain moments like the big meteorite falling on the earth, it is a threshold moment. And that changes life here. So he says there are 8 threshold moments. You can look at it yourself in the video. 8 moments when we made changes and we grew. Bible says God created the earth in 6 days and then he rested on the 7th day. Perfect. Except his 7 days were not as small as our 7 days. It's God's days. So it took 4.5 billion years for the human beings to arrive where we are today. It's a long period of life. The Greek word for a time, they use 2 words, chronos and kairos. Chronos is just time. Kairos is a celebrative time, an acceptable time, a Goldilocks moment. Things change. The Old Testament story of Noah, when the wicked grew in leaps and bounds, God said the providence takes charge. He sends a flood and wipes out all of them. What about Noah and his family? They must be protected. So he tells them to make this boat, ark. Make this, Noah made this ark. I can hear a motorcycle going, it's okay, I suppose. Noah's ark was a second creation. Male and female of every species, God protects and takes them through the history. And so God sometimes creates, sometimes does not create, sometimes is destroying. So the Chinese thought about it for thousands of years, and they have this idea of yin and yang. You know, neither, you know, it's not just goodness alone. Some evil is also, evil and goodness both are mixed together. Not only Chinese, in the Catholic tradition, we had Nicholas of Cusa and Gregory of Nazianzen, two saintly persons, and they brought up this idea, God is a, or reality is a coincidence of opposites. Coincidencia oppositorum. You know, God is a mixture of good and evil. It's a coincidence of opposites. I don't know how to understand that. If some of you understand it, fine. But then somehow I'll explain it further. See, in the Indian tradition, we have in India, there are three gods, Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesha, in one god. There's only one god, but there is a Brahma on the left. He's the one who creates. Vishnu in the middle, he preserves. And Shiva at the end, the right side, he destroys. A god, within the Godhead, there's a creator and a preserver and a destroyer. Coincidencia oppositorum. You know, that's another way of looking at God. COVID-19 times, what can we do when we are going through a period of uncertainty? Is it a ripe time of kairos? I don't know, you have to think about it. What happened to you last 5 or 6 months? Something happened, good or bad? You know, it's a crisis situation. Like Noah, maybe we are asked to build the ark. Noah built it with all possible wood, he made it. It's amazing work. And there is no literal flood today. But then today we have a crisis of survival. Maybe it's time for us to build the ark. Time to pray. Listen to the divine. See the picture of, in the picture, Noah is standing quietly and listening to God in his heart. Each one of us did that this 6 months. Did God whisper something in your heart? Something positive? That maybe thousands of people were motivated to do things. Maybe we are changing history in a positive way. The scientists will find a vaccine one of these months, and probably will come out of COVID, possibly. All of us are inspired from within. The other day we had a webinar with Jesuits from Madurai province and the rest of the provinces. And this was something which we all thought. All of us were inspired to do things, something positive. And this is the place I live, Shanti Sadan, Allahabad. It's a beautiful place. This
it's
a beautiful place with a lot of trees and quiet places to sit down. And I used to sometimes stand and wonder at the morning sunshine how beautiful a place could be. And I felt immensely happy to stand there under the trees and see the beauty all around me. And next door of our compound, there is a little village. And I came in contact with a few children, Renu and her siblings, very poor children. They did not seem to be worried or anxious. I went and talked to them. They were happy because an old man came to listen to them. We spent a lot of time. We have become friends. So these 6 months, a lot of time. We have a rare plant in our yard called Begum Bahar. It's a beautiful plant. The girls from the kitchen were the first ones to spot it flowering. this morning, they said, they called me and said, Father, the plant has flowered. It's a beautiful violet colored flower, not easily found. In fact, this campus has several trees and plants which are rare. And a great sense we feeling with the creation. That's what my experience. Whenever I stood next to the creation, I looked at them, and they are not away from me or apart from me. I am what I am because of them. They process carbon dioxide and convert into oxygen, and I can breathe and then I'm alive. Each one of us here in this webinar, you are breathing oxygen because the trees are working that for you. This creation is not something apart from you. It is you. You are a child of the earth like these trees. We don't have roots like the trees. We are free people, but our connection is through the nose. We are connected to the whole creation every moment. So when I used to sit on a small portico, the question was in my head, what should we do? What could be done in this holiday time or in this difficult time? And it was a question all of us in our community, we are asking the same thing. What should we do now? Probably it's a question, a course in your mind too. Why don't we start a genetic nursery? No, a genetic nursery is a nursery where varieties of trees and plants are grown. I've grown nursery last 30 years. So I said, why don't we start? I said, why not? So we started building a nursery. So we need workers. Since our main gate is locked, outsiders cannot come in. We are wondering who would help me to build this nursery. And then, you know, we found in our compound a particular variety of fruits known as ramphal or bullsard, they call it. Keeping our future, common future in mind, we said we could propagate these. It's a rare one. Ramphal or bullsard, it's called. And we got a boy. He helped me to build up this nursery. And my sister-in-law gifted me with 100 seeds of another rare tree called Hanuman Phal, Thoni Custard or a Sour Sops. The other day, Sister Mudita from Mumbai told us, this fruit is very expensive. 1,000 rupees for a kilogram of this fruit. And Bangalore is sold for 500 rupees for a kilo. Very expensive because nobody grows them. Then suddenly my sister-in-law gave me 100 seeds and I was so happy that she could think about that. That this is a nice gift from her to this season. So Tarimitra Nursery took off in Allahabad. And the kitchen staff volunteered to germinate the seeds of Hanuman Phal and Ram Phal. They filled poly bags and planted the seeds and looked after them, watered them. And Anamika and Rubina, two girls, picked up the nursery work very fast. And we have thousands of them now, saplings. You know, where there was no nursery, suddenly we have a flourishing nursery. Effort of the kitchen staff. 3,000 seedlings are ready now. And a rare collection of 3,000 seedlings in 2 months. Especially the Hanuman Phal, the Thoni Custard apple fruits, all of them, all the trees, saplings are booked. Now we had to somehow get more seeds and grow them. Big demand. And it's a sensitive work. It needs a lot of attention. And everybody is helping out. The whole community is involved. And the monsoon came. End of the summer, the monsoon came. A compound was flooded with plenty of water. And watering was no problem. Then a new idea. Devapriya is a girl from Patna. She coordinates Tarimitra activities today. Last year she was in Rome, met the Pope, and she was very happy to meet this holy man. And one day she called up and said, Father Robert, what about making some seed bombs? New idea, seed bombs. That is, take some mud, roll it into a ball and keep a seed inside. And when it is dry, you go and throw it out in the rain. Wherever there's an open place, throw them out. So we started making seed bombs. And probably we had about 10,000 seed bombs. And anybody could throw them. Our 10,000 seed bombs got ready. And scattering bombs, the seeds, you know, the seeds on the plate here can be spread in the whole city. Children love to do that. And they will go not only on the roadside, they will throw into the neighbor's compound. Wherever there is a place, they will throw it. And nobody can get angry with children. Throwing bombs on the roadside. See, this boy, I am driving, he is throwing them. So we threw these seed bombs all over the city of Allahabad. Over 10,000 seed bombs spread in the city. The seeds are germinating now with the rains. If 10% survive, we will have at least a minimum of 500 seeds, trees, 500 bohemia trees in Allahabad through the effort of 2-3 people. It's a beautiful tree with the red flowers in the winter, and the fruits are edible, the seeds are edible, the leaves are edible, and the flower petals are edible. And very hardy plant. We got a kilogram of seeds from Patna. Returning back to good old earth, we are reflecting on the earth. The earth has been spinning in the space very quietly, and all history took place on her. She is still spinning, there is life in her. And it's difficult to read. I'll read it aloud. By awakening the Native American teachings, you come to the realization that the earth is not something simply that you build upon and walk upon and drive upon and take for granted. It is a living entity. The earth has consciousness. The earth manages, arranges everything on the planet. So therefore she is called Mother Earth. India is taken for granted. Dharti Mata means God. The earth is always a mother. And she gives life to us, nourishes us, brings the rain, gives us the water. The earth has been embracing us in a great gesture of love. And the earth is always looked at as a mother. And not only Indian tradition, in the among the indigenous people of South America, America, they all thought alike. The earth is a great mother. Chief Seattle in 1854 went to the American president and he spoke, "The air is precious to the red man, for all things share the same breath. The beast, the tree, and the man, they all share the same breath. You can see I just poured a cup of black coffee.
Father cannot see the screen.
You cannot see?
Father, we can see.
Ah, okay.
Very small
presentation.
No, no, it is visible like before.
Prema, maybe your computer is not on.
Yes, correct. Father, it is okay. Go ahead.
Okay, The earth mother nourishes those who care for the whole. You know, it's a new concept. The earth mother nourishes those who care for the whole. If, for example, the dragon on the left is a Chinese dragon. There's a dragon crying. Okay, this dragon is a symbol of protection. It protects the earth. Like a mother cow looks after its calf, the earth looks after us. We can see examples of that. This dog here, she looked after all her pups. And then came a few kittens from somewhere. Well, she accepted them. The kitten grew with the pups very peacefully. I've seen it happening. The mother dog takes care of them. See, we can create enmity between a cat and a dog or a bird, but then you know they can live in peace. See, the earth removes anything that is not working for the well-being of the whole. See, the earth needs support. And the earth doesn't want anybody to become a destroyer and remove everybody. So the earth removes anything that is not working for the well-being of the whole. You know, it's a concept today ecologists are talking about. The earth invites us to care for the whole. And the Buddhist monks, wherever they went, they built up gardens. That's part of their spiritual life. The nuns and the monks, wherever they went, they planted gardens. And that has become part of our Catholic tradition. Let us stand in awe and silence on the earth and appreciate what takes place there. Not only the trees are growing, the animals are running around, but also from within the earth, there is movement to protect those in need, the helpless ones. The earth reaches out and the earth asks for support. Maybe you are a support for the earth. Maybe you will work. Maybe you will reach out. 2050, what will be the shape of the earth? Well, it's up to us to create that. Where is the earth or divine within us inviting us to? I got this whispering from within to start a nursery. Or Devapriya got this inspiration to throw seed bombs. I don't know what bombs you are throwing and what activity you are doing to protect, promote the whole. In honor, it's a beautiful song. Yeah, this is a beautiful song in all the Indian languages. And different people are singing. This is the last slide for me. Paying homage to the earth. That the song is saying that. The earth, O earth mother, We respect you, we revere you.
மண்ணில் மரமாக வீணில் மழையாக நலமே நல்கும் இயற்கையே ஆய்மையில் வடிவாக தெய்வத்தின் நிழலாக நடந்தாய் என்றென்றும் வாழியவே வாழியவே
Oh, Tara,
पास है सदा वंदन करे वसुंधरा
So that's the end of the presentation. Over to Sister Flory.
Yes, Father. Well, thank you so much for your beautiful presentation. I know you initially you had little difficulty, but it your beautiful presentation made it up for it. Thanks for taking us to the millions years back and then bringing us back to the human evolution. Thanks for the dragons and the fearful dinosaurs. I know we are happy that they are not here now, present time. Thank you, Father. Your life itself was so inspiring. In spite of this age, in no time, within these 2 months, you did such a beautiful, fruitful activity for environment to start the nursery, to plant 3,000 plants just with the help of two girls, kitchen girls, and your sister who donated you 100 seeds. It was really inspiring for us. And the novel idea given by Devu Priya from Patna, the seed bombs. It was really a novel idea. Many of us can also imitate it. Then the earth, as each of us, all of us do accept, we are nourished. Earth is our mother. Earth is always looked as a great mother to us. It heals us. And finally, the beautiful earth song. Thanks, Father. I know you took a lot of trouble in preparing us and inspiring us. I now invite the sisters, if you have any questions, doubts, please put in the chat box. Sister Venerasi, if anybody has put questions on the YouTube, kindly read them out to Father. Father, so far only comments are there. Thanking you for the good presentation, new ideas. Father, if there are, Father, please unmute yourself. Can't hear, Father. We can't hear. Father, please unmute.
Unmute. Father, unmute. Cannot hear. Father, unmute.
Flory, first he has to come out of the presentation. That presentation, he has to stop presentation, then he will be audible.
Okay.
You have to stop presentation. Robert, go back and that prayer. You have to stop the presentation, then you will be audible.
The presentation is written here. Father's self-presentation, is he reading this? I can't understand this one. Somebody's talking. I have no idea. He said, when I had confidence from him, he said, what is it, such an IT man? So this is how he cannot write.
Oh. What is it? Father Robert is not. I think Father can't unmute himself. Can the host help him out?
Robert, you have to go to your screen where you were presenting. Present now, and you have to stop presentation. Stop presentation. Then your voice will be audible. Where your PowerPoint is there, there you will press, and then you have to press there, then it will stop. Then you have to stop presentation. Then your voice will be audible. Have you found it, Robert? Unmute yourself. You're still muted. Unmute yourself. Robert, on the left hand side, down, unmute yourself. You are still muted. Unmute yourself. See the red icon?
I think he has left the meeting, Mudita. Okay.
Oh, yeah, he is. I can see him. I can see him. He's not left the meeting. He's here. I can see him. Robert, unmute yourself. The red icon on the left-hand side at the bottom of the screen.
I know from there, those who are hosting, they said he has left the meeting. Mudita.
I can see him here.
No, but the sisters are already leaving. I think we conclude the session.
Okay.
Glory.
Yes, sister.
Yeah, the sisters are already leaving. We conclude the session then.
Hello?
Yes, sister. I now invite... Yes. I would have been happy if Father had to give the closing comments. Since Father cannot unmute himself, I invite Sister Vinci to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good evening, sisters. On behalf of the whole congregation, Sisters of the Cross of Shavano, I'm here to say a big thank you to the organizers, CCROP, Croatian Consortium, to reach out to the periphery for this inspiring and valuable international webinar on approaches to eco-spirituality. Sister Prema, the coordinator of CCROP, hats off to you and your team for organizing this webinar for all the sisters of our congregation so that we grow in eco-spirituality. We are grateful to Father Robert Atikal SJ, the speaker for today's webinar, for your vibrant and enthusiastic session. You shared your knowledge and experience with us in simple words on the spirituality of the whole universe. Thank you, Father. Sister Flory, you deserve a big thank you for moderating today's webinar, and we appreciate your efforts to encourage all of us to live the eco-spirituality in our daily life as Sisters of the Cross. Not forgetting all the participants for your availability and active participation. Thank you very much, sisters.
Thank you, Sister Vinci. We end the session today and we look forward for our next session on the 30th September, same time. Thank you and God bless you. And we ask your pardon for the inconvenience caused. Thank you, sisters.
Your father has already left.
Father is still there. You look at the people, he's still there.
Good evening.
Father has to unmute.
Good evening. Father is not able to talk.
You have to unmute, Robert.
Hello, Sister Florine. Good evening.
No, he can't come up.
Hello.
Hi, Florine.
Sister Mudita, thank you very much.
Robert is still unmuted.
This is IV.
Thank you, sister. Sister Mary.